Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today I'm going to show you guys the best settings for Sony Vegas 13 in 2017. Now, if you want to have a professional 1080 60fps look, here are the settings I use. These are my new settings, so old videos that you've seen on my channel, they don't show this, but trust me, these look good. So I have this basic intro here. Nothing too special, but I'm going to show you how we can render this to make it look really good. So first we're going to go to properties here, just go file, and then file, properties. This is what we have here. I already have this set up, but I'm just going to go through it here. Width is going to be 1920 and height's going to be 1080, so that way it's 1080. Field order here, you're going to set to none, progressive scan. Pixel aspect ratio, we're just going to keep it at 1 square. Output ratio, we're just going to keep it at 0 original. And then frame rate, you want to set this to the 59.940 double NTSC. And then this stereoscopic 3D mode, we're just going to leave that off. Pixel format, we're going to keep it at 8-bit. And then the full resolution rendering quality is, we're going to put that on good. We don't want to put it on best because that's going to really eat up your it's gonna hurt your computer. You don't want that. Maybe if you have a super buffed up computer and you got time to kill, then best is your way to go, but I keep it a good. We're gonna keep motion blur type at Gaussian and deinterlace method blend fields. We're just gonna keep that, and we're just going to adjust source media to better match project or render settings. We're just gonna leave that checked. So that's all for project properties. Now, up here, we want to set it to best and then full. That way we're getting the best quality, the full quality that we're going to see this video at. So it would be 1080 60fps. Of course, I don't have gameplay to put in here at 60fps. So you're just going to have to try it out for yourself. It's good to experiment. But once we're done rendering, or once we're done making our video or whatever, we're just going to select the region loop, and we're going to go to render as, uncheck that. We're going to go to render as, and then we're going to go to main concept, AVC/AAC MP4 AVC. This is where you're going to go, and you're going to scroll down until you see Internet HD 1080p. You're going to go ahead and you're going to click customize template. Don't click render yet. We're going to customize this template, and the settings we are going to be using, we're going to leave this just like that. HD 1080. We're going to leave it. Allow source to adjust frame rate. We don't want that, so keep that unchecked. Profile, we're going to keep it at main. Frame rate, we're going to put this to 60. So you're going to have to type in 60 there. Allow source to adjust frame rate. We want to uncheck that because we don't want that again. Field order, we're going to keep it none, progressive scan. And our pixel aspect ratio, we are going to keep it at 1. The number of reference frames, we're going to keep it 2, and we're going to leave this use deblocking filter unchecked. Constant bit rate, we're going to leave unchecked. But this variable bit rate right here, we're going to set this first value to 24 and then the second one to 12. So it's just base number of slices. We're going to use 4. In code, we are going, this is actually up to how good of a computer you have. If you want to check what you can use to render, go down to system and check GPU. CUDA is available, so I would press render using CUDA if available. And this enable progressive download, we are going to leave it. This audio tab, we are going to leave this at 48, and the bit rate we are going to tone down to 96. Your audio is still going to sound fine. It just, you don't really have a whole need to set it up really high. It's not going to really change it too much. Your project is interesting here. We're going to go to video rendering quality and set this to best. That is what makes it look really nice because the rendering quality is to its fullest potential. So set that to best and then leave stereoscopic 3D mode. You're going to use project settings and color space default. That'll be fine. And we're just going to name this test. And we're going to wait for that to render. It's going to render fairly quickly. I've got CUDA being rendered right now, or rather, it was available to use. Now, I'm sure there are some more settings that you can fiddle around with to make it even better, but currently, these are what I feel would make a good v quality video, 1080p, 60fps video, currently in 2017. We're gonna go ahead and check here. We're gonna test. I want to turn down my volume a bit. It's a bit loud. And that's pretty good. I'm happy with that. Nice quality video there. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you learned something, make sure you hit that like button, show that love and support, leave a comment down below, let me know what you think about these settings, and check out my channel. It takes 2 minutes, and you won't regret it. Thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you guys all next time. Goodbye.